Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, in this video we are going to see three op-amp instrumentation amplifier. We have seen what is the block diagram and what are the different blocks present in the instrumentation amplifier and how it can be used to control some kind of actions. So now this instrumentation amplifier can be designed by using the op-amp, that is operational amplifier. So particularly it can be IC741. So we need to have a three op-amp where first two op-amp will be voltage buffer and the third one will be the difference amplifier. So in this video, let's see how this three op-amp instrumentation amplifier works. So here we have a three op-amp instrumentation amplifier circuit diagram is drawn, where you can see the three op-amp name is given as A1, A2 and A3, where A1 and A2, these two amplifiers are voltage follower, where we know the voltage follower are also known as a unity gain buffer because the gain of the voltage amplifier is equal to 1. Here also you can see the V1 is applied to the positive terminal and V2 is applied to the positive terminal. Now without anything, the negative terminal is connected directly to the output port. That means it is having the unity gain, or it is a voltage follower, because whatever voltage is at the positive terminal, the same voltage is present at the inverting terminal and which is connected over here. So I will name it accordingly. I'll name here as a V01 because the V1 is connected to A2. Then I will name this as equal to V1 because V1 is connected to non-inverting terminal, but by virtual short and virtual ground concept, this terminal will also remain at the same potential. So since V1 is the voltage given to the non-inverting terminal, so by virtual short and virtual ground concept, inverting terminal of the same op-amp will also remain at the same potential. So here at inverting also we have voltage is equal to V1, which is given to at this point. So I have named this point as a V1. Similarly, V2 is the voltage given to the A1, operational amplifier 1, for non-inverting terminal. So by virtual short concept, inverting terminal will also remain at the same potential, that is V2. So here I will name this particular point is equal to V2 and this point is equal to V02 because this is nothing but the output of the op-amp where V2 is applied and this is the output of op-amp where V1 is applied. Now depending on this, we will find out the final output of op-amp, where this operational amplifier, you can see this is nothing but if you see only this configuration, this is your difference amplifier. Now let's derive the output voltage for the three op-amp instrumentation amplifier. You all remember, you have seen the R1 and this R1 and this R1 are having the same value, which are connected in the output terminal and the input terminal. That means R1 is nothing but it's a feedback resistor, where R2 is the potentiometer. If you see the arrow is shown, that means you can vary the value of R2. You can change the value of R2 to adjust the gain and voltage appropriately. Similarly, if they are having the same value and they are connected in the output of the different op-amp, the current flowing through this resistor is same. The current flowing through this resistor is also I, and current flowing through this resistor will also remain I. You can write a vice versa. Now depending on this current direction, we will write the current equation first and then we can go for the difference amplifier. In difference amplifier, R4 is nothing but your feedback resistor. So here, depending on the input given to the inverting terminal, this difference amplifier will amplify the signal, and that will be V0 into the closed loop gain of an amplifier into VD, where VD will be nothing but V01, that is the voltage which is coming from here, minus V02. So your VD will remain V01 minus V02. Now to get the difference, to get the output, we should know the AVF, that is a closed loop voltage gain, and the difference voltage between these two input. So the difference is V01 and V02. So to get the difference value, you first need to find out V01 and V02. So let's start with the derivation. So this is the expression for output voltage. Depending on the diagram shown, I can write down the current equation I is equal to I. So this can be written from point 1, that is operational amplifier, to V01 minus V1 divided by R1 is equal to V1 minus V2 divided by R2 is equal to V2 minus V02 divided by R1. This equation I have got from this diagram like this. So the current flowing through this branch can be written as V01 minus V1 divided by R1, V1 minus V2 divided by R2, and V2 minus V02 divided by R1. This is the equation we have got over here. Now I want to find out what is the value of V02. This is what I need to find out to get the formula Vd is equal to V01 minus V02. I will equate this first, that is to get the V01 value. So here I will write V01 minus V1 divided by R1 is equal to V1 minus V2 divided by R2. If you simplify this, you will get the value of V01, and that is equal to R1 divided by R2 minus V1 minus V2 plus V1. If you rearrange this particular equation, I will name it as A, then you will get the equation 1, where R1 is a feedback resistance and R2 is a output or load resistance, you can say. And V1 and V2 are the different input voltage given to that particular amplifier. So here I have got the V01. Next, I will equate these two equations so that I will get the V02. So here I have written V1 minus V2 divided by R2 is equal to V2 minus V02 divided by R1. Here I need to have V02, so I will simplify this whole equation. I will name it as a B, and I will get the value of V02, that is minus of R1 divided by R2, V1 minus V2 plus V2, and this is the equation 2. So I have got the equation 1 and equation 2. Now I want to find out the output voltage, that is V0 is equal to the closed loop gain of an amplifier into Vd, but Vd is equal to V01 minus V02. So I have got for a V01 and I have got the expression for V02. So let's substitute into the output voltage expression so that I will get the final output. So now A3 is a difference amplifier. As I have explained, the third operational amplifier used in instrumentation is a difference amplifier. So output voltage of a difference amplifier, since it is an inverting configuration, gain can be written as a minus R4 divided by R3. If you see this difference amplifier, since it is an inverting configuration, this is your feedback resistance and this is your input resistance. So you can write AVF is equal to minus of R4 divided by R3. This is the closed loop gain. And output voltage can be decided by V01 minus V02, that is Vd. So here I have written the equation V0 is equal to minus R4 divided by R3 into V01 minus V02. Now we have find out what is V01 and what is V02. So let's substitute equation 1 and equation 2 in the above equation. You will get minus R4 divided by R3 into R1 divided by R2 V1 minus V2 plus V1. Plus, now the minus sign of equation 2 will become plus because you are subtracting the second equation, so minus minus will become positive. So here you will get positive R1 by R2 into V1 minus V2, and this positive V2 will get negative sign. So if you simplify this, you can see this V1 minus V2 is a common, or this two term are common. So you can write this V1 minus V2 separately, that is this bracket. Plus, you have twice number of this parameter. So, plus 2 R1 by R2 V1 minus V2. Now, this bracket also, the V1 minus V2 and V1 minus V2 is common. So, I take this out, minus R4 by R3 into V1 minus V2 in common. So, in bracket, what you will get? 1 plus twice of R1 by R2. So, you can write it this way. So, this V0 divided by V1, that means I am writing V0 divided by Vd is nothing but the gain of the instrumentation amplifier, AVF. This is the closed loop gain of the instrumentation amplifier, where Vd is nothing but V0 divided by V1. 1 minus V2, which is nothing but this. So this expression is nothing but the gain of instrumentation amplifier, and this expression is nothing but the output voltage of an instrumentation amplifier. So this is the derived. That means you can see here the working principle or working of instrumentation amplifier is completely depend upon the difference amplifier gain and the input and potentiometer. So you can adjust the value of potentiometer, you can adjust the value of resistor, you can adjust the gain by changing the feedback resistor or input resistor of a difference amplifier, and by changing the resistance values you can control the application or you can control the parameters which are required to be controlled. So this is how the instrumentation amplifier works. Thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ekida. Do subscribe Ekida. Thank you so much.